My grandma used to say, like, if he could see, it'd be dangerous. And I think it might well have been. When I was born, there was all sorts of complications and the heart condition, and they said we're not sure he can hear or whether he's like can speak or anything like that. So they said I wasn't gonna ride a bike, I wasn't gonna do this, that, and the other, and it just forced like my mum and dad just said, I'm not having any of that. You know, wherever we went to, you know, it's just like Si's gonna be able to do that. You know, it's just because other kids are doing it, like he's definitely gonna be able to do it as well, and it all stemmed from them. Pushing me and making me believe, actually, you can go and do it. Because it'd be very easy to just say, oh, well, you know, I can't see very well, so I can't do that. But that was never, ever an option. You know, but at school, it was tough. She used to get beaten up and things like that. And my shoulder broken once, and I was determined to not stay off school. I'm sure those years set me in good stead to be strong, because you had to be. You just had to pick yourself up and get on with it and, you know, overcome your demons and go places you didn't want to go, go back to school every day, go out, you know, make sure that you didn't just stay at home. And so, you know, all of that was going on, and my parents had to make a pretty tough decision, you know, whether to send me away to boarding school. And that was probably the hardest decision they ever had to make, but they sent me. And it's the best thing they could have done for me. It sent me to a place where, you know, other people had a visual impairment and stuff like that, but cricket was really popular at that school, and the school had a reputation for it. And yeah, like, just got into it straight away, really. I enjoyed the fact that there was a lot of different pressures. I enjoyed the fact that there were so many different roles in the game. It wasn't just like football. You know, I really felt like you won as a team, you lost as a team. But yeah, I got noticed, I got invited to an England trial when I was 14, and got lucky, I think. And then I went to a World Cup when I was 16. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, I never ever wanted to go to uni. I never wanted to go. I guess, you know, my family wanted me to go. My mum put a lot of pressure on me to go to uni, which, you know, is probably fair enough, like, you know, especially, you got a visual impairment, like you need a degree, you need a qualification, and that's all fair enough, isn't it? But I mean, it was a daunting thing as well, because you were going back into that mainstream setting. Not that I didn't have friends that were mainstream, but you go back into that mainstream setting where, again, you're the different one. Like, and so that was daunting for me. I ended up down in Brighton.
There's like 7 bedrooms, and this is my gaff. This is my one here. So I had the lower floor room. You've got the flat roof, and out the back, you just go up into the flat roof. You know, that party's up there. Yeah. Neighbours hated us. I was big into my fitness and stuff, like when I first went to uni, and I tried to carry that on. And but then, you know, everyone was in the drug game around here. A lot of pressure to be in that and doing that. But just really because of the crowd I fell into, really. And it all just built from there, and it was just an opportunity to make a bit of money. I knew of other people that were doing it just on a real small time basis. And then I moved in with a group of my mates into here. And it just so happened that at least 3 of them were sort of into doing that. That room there used to, we had all the plants in there, so my mate lived in there, and he decided that he would have all the plants and allergen plants in his room. God knows what that did to him, and it all got a bit heavy, and you know, you have people in the front room doing crack and stuff like that. It's just, it wasn't for me. None of that was for me. It feels a bit weird being back here, because it's about 8 years since I've been here, and you just, like, things enter your head, don't they, like, of what you used to do. And because, I don't know, you can think of things 8 years ago and it doesn't seem very long at all. But when you consider how much my life has changed and where it could have been, it's actually a hell of a lot has happened, so. Yeah, look, you know, it was things escalated quite a lot, I suppose. You know, when we've got a bit of a grow operation going on, and there was more money to be had, and people were interested in, you know, and asking for different types of gear, you know. And I used to pick up in this area from a guy pretty well known at that time. It's been a pretty big dealer, and I got a reasonable amount off him, and I walked out of the house, and there was no other way to go. I had to go the way I was going, and there was a police car there, and two, a police woman and a police man, and they both looked at me. Now, they knew exactly where I'd come from. They'd seen me come out of the house, so they knew what I'd been doing, and, you know, for all intents and purposes, they knew that I had something on me, but I guess they didn't know exactly what I had on me. And that's probably what saved my bacon, to be honest, is the fact that they were looking at him and they were looking at that house. So I walked past as confidently as I could and scarfed, got rid of whatever I had, and then just shut myself in my room. And I was bricking it a little bit. And because what I had on me, I probably would have got 6 years if I'd have been. Yeah, that gave me the kick up the bum I needed to, so to say, you've been pretty lucky, you're riding your luck now, and to probably have a little bit of a think about your life and what you're doing. So at that time I was in a really bad way, and you know, my mate Andy gave me a call and said, look, you know, come down to this session at Sussex Cricket Club. And he was heavily involved with the juniors, so he was coaching all the juniors and getting them through. But he said, look, you know, I'm desperate. I haven't really got anyone to come and help me. Whether that was true or not, I'm not sure. I doubt it. But he tries his damnedest to get me there, and you know, in the end, I did it for him. It took me right out of my comfort zone because I was in my bubble. You know, like I was just with the guys that I would roll around with every single day, and we were doing the same things, and just got comfortable with that. So helping those kids was brilliant. It just gave me a sense of like doing something that was productive and that mattered. And actually I realised, you know, the rest of my days in that week, I wasn't doing anything really. Like I may have thought it was cool and like I was having a good time, but actually I really wasn't having a good time at all. I guess it sparked me into realising I needed to grow up, be an adult, sort my life out, and stop wasting my days really. So he said, look, just come along once a week, you know, come and coach the juniors once a week. And it just so happened that once the juniors had finished training, the seniors would turn up. So, you know, it was more likely that I was going to be able to to play as well and train myself. Got a lot of people to thank really, but yeah, it wouldn't have happened. That day, it all started here. And that's work and cricket and the whole lot all come together. So cricket's given me an amazing opportunity to travel, to go to all these amazing places in the world and get to pull on the jersey and represent your country. You can't buy that. I'm just grateful to be there and grateful to have had the experiences to do it. I was a very, very unlikely cricketer, I think it's fair to say. And I think there should be a lot more people that take up the game that don't think they're going to be cricketers. Cricket teaches you about life. More than any other sport, I think, does. You know, there's degrees of responsibility, your teamwork. You have to take responsibility for your own actions, but also the team's actions. Just give it a go. It's a really good sport.